We gather once again as a family of God. We gather as always in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our failures and our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have the care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved. And in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are the master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much lenience you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones, according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus proposed a parable to the crowds, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat, and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, 'Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?' He answered, 'An enemy has done this.' His slaves said to him, 'Do you want us to go and pull them up?' He replied, 'No, if you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let us grow them together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Each week, as we read and reflect on the Sunday Gospels particularly, they provide an opportunity for us to reflect and make our own the teachings of Jesus. And there are a variety of ways that we can approach these readings and thus approach Jesus' teaching. As I reflect on sharing a homily, I usually find like two major themes in the scriptures. The first is what I call a macro focus. The world, the big issues that touch us, and how we need to address those. We need to understand what Jesus teaches about prejudice, or poverty, or family difficulties, struggles of faith, and many more questions. Jesus wants his word to make the world better through our listening, reflecting, and living out his message. A second theme is more focused. It means listening to the teaching of Jesus that is focused specifically on the individual, on each of us. And I think that this gospel provides a teaching that can help us improve our lives as disciples of Jesus. So this morning, reflect a bit on the wheat and the weeds. The gospel seems to describe two camps, the good and the evil, that we either on the good side or the bad side. However, I don't think such a dichotomy is really accurate. More accurately or correctly, we are all weeds and wheat people. There is both for us an inner awareness and outer behavior. We live in a world that is not perfect, so that's why we are both weeds and wheat. We find ourselves trying to realize, but also realize that there's a fracture in our life. This morning, what I would like us to do is to ask ourselves, how frequently do we actually learn from this gospel about the weeds and the wheat? My guess is that human behavior, especially at a time like this, has us gravitate to the weeds. We become aware of our sinfulness, our less perfect side. But I'd rather have us think about not so much what we do wrong, what the things that we are embarrassed about, but rather to think about the wheat. What is the wheat in your life? What are the good things that you do in your life? Who or what have you brought to life? Do you take for granted the good that you plant? Are you embarrassed or pay no attention? So the gospel is about the good and the bad, both part of life. But this morning I encourage you to reflect on the good that you do. Do not let the weeds take over. When we fail, we do feel humiliated. We're brought back to the truth. We are not perfect. But we do not need to be discouraged because we find some weeds in our life. But rather, we have to be the people who preach the word of Jesus, because he is the one who brings the goodness and the wheat to life. And so today, think about the good things that you do. Give thanks to God for the grace that he gives you. During especially this time, we are people of goodness, not darkness. We live together, but in the end, we are the people that overcome the evil and the bad things and are ministers of the good and the positive. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now in trust and confidence, we make our needs known. We pray for the church. We pray for our leadership, for our Holy Father, for our Archbishop, and for all who provide leadership and ministry in our church. We pray to the Lord. Hear our prayer. We pray for civic leaders. They may be very conscious of the needs of their people and give their service in justice and care. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are ill, for their caregivers, especially those suffering from the virus, that they may know God's healing love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the many who have been out of work, who are suffering in need, that they might be assisted and strengthened. For them we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for those who have died, that they might have eternal rest. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. All-powerful and ever-living God, hear these prayers, those spoken, those in our heart. They are made in trust and confidence in Jesus' name, who lives forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion the varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what we each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
On you stay, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you stay, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you stay, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those we have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And have a wonderful day. Stay well.